गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द फर्स्ट सेशन ऑफ डेटा इंटरप्रिटेशन। दिस इज अ बेसिक सेशन। इन दिस सेशन वी ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आर द बेसिक रिक्वायरमेंट्स फॉर सॉल्विंग द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ द डीआई। इन द स्टार्टिंग सेशंस वी जस्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंट कॉन्सेप्ट्स दैट आर बीइंग यूज्ड एज वेल एज द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, द डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ ग्राफ्स। Now, before starting with the session, data interpretation, first of all, we try to understand the meaning of it as well as importance of it as per to our competitive examinations. Data interpretation is simply interpretation of the data which is provided to us in the forms of the tables, pie charts, bar graphs, caselets, right? Now, for solving the questions of the data interpretation, the first important point is that in different competitive exam, what is the importance of it? When I talk about banking exam, IBPS, either it's for the clerical or bank PO or specialized officers, DI plays a very important role. Out of the mathematics, around 60% of the questions are from DI. If 50 questions are there, so you can expect around 25 to 30 questions they are being generally asked from the concept of data interpretation, because examiner is more concerned about the application of mathematical concepts. And in DI, you know that you have to apply the concept of percentage, your calculations, averages, and basic understanding of the questions. Similarly, in State Bank of India, PO exam, in mains, all questions are from DI. Whole mathematics is primarily based on data interpretation, right? No questions of mathematics have been generally asked. The maximum portion of the mathematics is covered as a part of DI. Then, in SSC, in pre-exam, only one set is given of 5 questions, and in mains exams, around 15 questions are from the DI. The type of question that have been asked in SSC exam is comparatively very simple. They are not that much of complicated as compared to the IBPS or State Bank of India examinations. And lastly, we have management entrance examinations that have CAT, ZAT, you have IAFT, NMAT, and number of other management entrance examinations. Now, in management entrance examinations, DI plays a very, very important role. Why? Because in management entrance examination, the prime objective of the examiner is to make a paper in such a way that the prospective managers can be found, right? And the data interpretation is practically used as a part of management examinations. In CAT examination for the pattern of 2015, from 50 questions of the mathematics, around 20 questions will be from the DI. There would be around 20 questions from the DI. Similarly, in IFT exam, a separate part of the DI is there. In ZAT exam, questions are asked for the DI. Now, the type of questions in IBPS and PO exam, the difficulty level is medium. In SSC exam, it is simple. In SB exam, we can say that is moderate. It is more than medium. We can say more than medium, right? And when I talk about the management examination CAT, it's difficult. Okay? Now, you will find in number of sessions, first I will start with the basic sessions that is for the IBPS examinations, and that are also very helpful for the CAT students also in order to better understand the concept, right? And in further, I will also provide some sessions on management entrance examination point of view, CAT, ZAT, IFT, right? So that is a basic introduction about the importance of the DI in different examinations. Now, the next point that we try to understand here, what concept of the mathematics are involved in DI? Means, what are the basic things that are required for solving the questions of DI, right? When we start with the basic things for solving the questions of the DI, the first important point is, concept of percentage. Important point is concept of percentage, right? Now, although for better understanding of the percentage, you may watch my basic sessions of percentage on the my channel on YouTube. But in this session, I just state you what are the basic requirements of percentage that you need, what are the basic things so that you may better understand, and I will also show you in some questions how to use that, right? In percentage, two things are there. First deals with the calculation part. For calculation part, you are required to cram the values of 100%, this is equal to 1, 1 by 2, this is equal to 50%, 1 by 3, this is equal to 33.33%, 1 by 4, this is equal to 25%, 1 by 5, that is equal to 20%, 1 upon 6, 16.66%, 1 upon 7, 14.28%, 1 upon 8, 12.5%, 1 upon 9, 11.11%, 1 upon 10, that is said to be 10%, 1 upon 11, 9.09%, 1 upon 12, that is 8.33%, 1 upon 13, 7.69%, 1 upon 14, 7.14%, 1 upon 15, 6.66%, 1 upon 16, 6.25%, right? These values are required by you. These values must be crammed by you, because at some place, suppose you have to find out 7.8% of a number, right? Here, approximation plays a very important role. Suppose you have to find out 7.7% of a number, it's better to find 7.69%, that is divided by 13, right? Means there, approximation plays a very important role, because in DI, you are not expected to find the exact answer, right? If there is a gap in the options, you have to take the help of approximation. In this session, I will also speak on approximation, how to go for approximate. But first, we are talking about the basic percentage table, right? Now, that thing must be crammed by you. After that, few more things are also expected from you. What those things are there? 1 by 3, you know that 33.33%, 2 by 3, this is equal to 66.66%, right? 25% is 1 by 4, 3 by 4 is said to be 75%, right? 1 by 6, 16.66, 5 by 6 is said to be 83.33%, 1 by 8, 12.5, you may say here, 3 by 8, 37.5%, 5 by 8, 62.5%, 7 by 8, 87.5%, right? That must be remembered by you. At any place, if you have 88% of a number, it's better go for 7 by 8, right? Why? Because you know that that is quite close to 87.5, and we can easily find 7 by 8, right? Similarly, you know that 1 by 9 is 11.11%, okay? Now, if I make 2 by 9, right? 2 by 9 makes it 22.22%. It is 22.22%, right? If I say 4 by 9, it makes me 44.44%. 5 by 9, 55.55%. Now, I have this thing in my mind that at any place, if my number is going to be repeated, like 77.77%, right? It must come in my mind that is equal to approximately 7 by 9, okay? Then 1 by 11 is 9.09%, 2 by 9 is 18.18%, 5 by 9 is 45.45%, right? And so on. Now it is up to you how much table you remember in your mind, right? Because at any place, suppose you require 46%. You have 5 by 9 in your mind. If you have 5 by 9, it's easy for you to calculate, right? Similarly, you may extend it, but these are some basic values that must be known to you, right? Now, one more thing is expected from you, because here I have taken my maximum value to be 100%, that is equal to 1, right? The second point must be known to you here that if your value exceed 100%, right? Suppose in a question you are required to find 108.33% of 137.5% of a number. Suppose number is 240. You need to find that, right? Or you have to approximately find 138%, right? Now, what you can say? Because here 108.33, right? From here, I can easily say 8.33, that you know, that is equal to 1 by 12, right? Now, in my mind, what I will think? 100 plus 8.33, that you have to do in your mind. There is no need to write, right? 100% is 1 and 8.33 is 1 by 12. 1 plus 1 by 12 would be taken as 13 by 12. That you can say into 137.5. What I can say now? 137.5. 37.5 is 5 by 8. 37.5, sorry, that is 3 by 8. Now, 1 plus 3 by 8, that is 11 by 8. Right, into 240, that you can say. Okay, now just solve it. 12 will go on 20, 4 will go on 2, 4 will go on 5. Now, it depends on your calculation. 13 into 11, 143. 143 into 5, I can easily find out. That is said to be 715 by 2. Now, I can solve it very easily, right? And I also expect from you to watch my two sessions on Vedic Mathematics on speed calculations that are available on my channel on YouTube at the rate Adinesh Miglani. Earlier in starting, you may find those sessions. Do watch those sessions, because in those sessions, I have discussed number of calculation techniques, right? And if you have a good command on calculations, because some standard techniques are there that may be used in order to answer the questions, right? So all this will help you out, right? I hope the idea is clear. So that is the first point that is required from you, is concept of percentage. That table must be remembered by you. Okay? Now, let us take the second point of this structure of the introduction class of the DI. Second point that we must be known to us is calculation, how percentage is obtained. Or I can say, how percentage is obtained. For better understanding this, I just try to draw a table. Let us say there are two persons. From here we understand a few more things. Suppose A and B, two persons are there, right? And their monthly salaries are given for the month of January, February, March, April, May and June. Right, that is 2500, 3000, 4500, 6000, 8000, 10000. And when I talk about for B, this is 3000, 4000, 6000, 7500, 9000, and 12000. These are given to you, right? Two persons are there, their monthly salary have been stated to you, right? Okay, now here we try to understand for finding the percentage. Suppose that if I say, first basic question is, if I ask you, A salary in May is how much percentage more than B salary in February? B salary in February. Now, that's a general question. In this question, we only require only single information, right? What is asking us? A salary in May, that is 8,000, and B salary in February, that is 4,000, is how much percentage more, right? So, what I can say, how much is more? 4,000, and our comparison with B is 4,000 into 100. So, what is my answer? I can say my answer is said to be 100%, okay? Now, for understanding of all these things, you may watch my session of percentage. There I told you how we compare. What is the basic formula for comparing? That I told you. What we compare, that always comes in numerator. What we compare, that always comes in numerator. Divided by to whom we compare. Divided by to whom we compare, that always comes in denominator into 100. That is the basic concept to percentage. In any question of percentage, if you have to make a comparison, the fundamental point that you are expected to do, what we compare and to whom we compare. Here is a direct question. salary of A in May is how much percentage more than salary of B in February? So my answer is very simple, 8,000, 4,000. What is that increase? 4,000. So I can say 100% is my answer, right? Let us take the second question here. Monthly salary of A in May and June is what percentage of monthly salary of B in May and June? Right? Here the question is, salary of A in the month of May and June is what percentage of salary of B in the month of May and June? Right? What I can say? Salary of A in May and June, that is 18,000 total. Because here I have to directly compare. I have to compare the salary of A with B. So what I can say, salary of B is 9,000 plus 12,000, that is, I can say 21,000 into 100. That's my question. Right, now it would be cancelled out. 3637, that I can say. Now, the next point here, I must have in my mind, I know that 1 by 7 is 14.28%. I have to find 6 by 7, just multiply by 6, right? So you are going to get here, 6 and 48, 8, carry 4, 12 and 4, 16, 6, carry 1, 24 and 1, 25, 5, carry 2, 6 to 8. So your approximate answer is 85.68%, that becomes your answer. I hope the idea is clear, right? Now, the next point that we try to understand in this, if I ask you, what is the percentage increase? It's a very important thing. What is the percentage increase in salary of A from January to June? Question is, what is the percentage increase in salary of A from January to June? Right? Now, what I can say, A salary in the month of January is 2500. In June, it becomes equal to 10,000. Okay? I have to find the percentage change. There is no need to look in the between values. In any question where you have to find the percentage change, and from a particular year to any other year, right? In that question, there is no need to look in between values. You know that 2500 to 10,000, what is the change? Increase 7500. It is being increased from 2500 into 100. So what I can say? Answer is said to be 300%. So here I can say that overall percentage change in salary of A from January to June, that is said to be 300%, right? If a comparison have to be made in two particular years, in two particular month, in that case, there is no need to look in between. In between, there is no need to look. We have to just directly compare and we can answer our question. Okay? That point we will take care when I'm going to explain you the concept of simple growth, right? Compounded growth, simple annual growth. But here we are just going to look at the basic concept of percentage required in this, right? Next question is, in which month increase in A salary, increase in A's salary is maximum? Or you may say change in A salary is maximum. Now one thing you have to take care of, when I say change, so change may include two things, increase as well as decrease. In any question when change is there, so change include two things, increase as well as decrease. But here it is specifically increase, right? Here question is, in which month increase in A salary maximum, right? Now, one thing you have to take care of that, here is concerned with increase. It's an absolute value. He is concerned with absolute value. He is nowhere concerned with percentage value, right? So just compare. 500, 1500, 1500, 2000 and 2000, right? So I can say in 2 months, the change is maximum. So about the months are May and April. Because in April it was 6,000, in May it was 8,000. So I can say from April to May, total change was 2,000, right? Similarly, in June it was 10,000. So I can say in which particular month the change was maximum. So 2 months are there, May and June. Because if I compare from the previous value, so I can say 2,000 have been increased, okay? Now the next point is, if we ask you percentage change, if we ask you percentage increase, in February, what is the percentage change? 2500 to 3000. 500. So I can say 500 by 3000 into 100, 16.66%. Now I have to compare in which is the maximum. Now you cannot say in both areas is the maximum. No. Why? Because here it is But 2000 is absolute change. And here we are concerned with the percentage change. Okay, now from 3000 to 4500, what is the percentage change? 1500, that is 50%. Okay, 6000 to 8000, because absolute change is maximum here. But here question is percentage change. So here I can say increases 2000 by 6000, you can say 33.33%. Okay, so here there is a need to understand the difference. When I talk about the absolute change would be here, 2000. But if I talk about percentage change is here. 3000 to 4500, so I can say there is an increase of 50%, so maximum change is here, right? So that in the question we have to understand that either he is only concerned with increase or he is concerned with percentage increase. If he is concerned with simply increase, right? So in that case, what is expected from us? Just take absolute value, take the difference, okay? If he is going to ask you percentage increase, in the question of percentage increase, what is expected from your side? In percentage increase, you have to find the percentage and then you have to answer your question, right? The next point that we try to understand is, we have the three basic concept of percentage that is required in this chapter that have been generally used. First one is simple growth rate. There is a need to understand between them, simple growth and simple growth rate, right? The second point is average growth rate, or we can say annual growth rate. That may also be taken as annual growth rate, right? Fourth point that we have to understand, compounded annual growth rate. Okay, now for better understanding the concept, let us draw a table. From year 1999, total production was 2 lakh rupees. For year 2000, total production was 2,50,000. For 2001, total production was 3,50,000. For 2002, total production was 4,50,000. And for 2003, total production was 6 lakh. This information is provided to us, right? Here the data that is given to us, that data is stated to us, the total production of 5 companies, okay? For 99, 2000, 2001, 2002 and 2003, okay? Now, first is asking us, in which year simple growth is maximum? In which year simple growth is maximum? And we know that the growth is always compared from the previous year, right? Now, when I say simple growth, we are concerned with absolute value. Right? Now, here it is 50,000, here it is 1 lakh. It's 1 lakh, is 1 lakh 50,000, right? Here I can say my simple growth is maximum in the year of 2003, right? Why? Because when I talk about simple growth, that is simply deals with absolute change, right? My answer is said to be 2003, okay? Second is simple growth rate, okay? Now, two types of questions are there. One is simple growth rate in any 2 years. If I ask you, in the given information, in which year the simple growth rate is maximum as compared to the previous year, right? Now, here we are concerned with the simple growth rate in any 2 years, okay? Now, just check out 2 lakh to 2,50,000. Increase is 50,000. So, I can say that is 25% is increase. Here it is 1 lakh. Right, that is 40% increase. Here it is 1 lakh, I may say 1 lakh by 35,000, right? Now go for approximation. Why? If I say 1 lakh by 35,000, right? So I can somewhere say that would be taken as 10 by 35 into 100. That's my approximate value, right? And here if I say 1 lakh 50,000 by 4 lakh 50,000, I can say 1 by 3, or you can say 33.33%. That you can say, right? My question is, in which year it is the maximum and it is the minimum? So I can say in 2001 it is maximum, because if I compare from the previous year, 2003 is my, in 2001 that is maximum, that is 40%, okay? Now if I ask you the minimum, now in minimum, two values may be there. In 2003, answer is 33.33%. In 2002, it is 1 by 35 into 100. Now you have to make a comparison whether this is more than 33.33% or this is less than 33.33%. Okay. If it is 1 by 30, if it is 10 by 30, then it is 33.33%. Here you have 10 by 35, right? You know that 10 by 35 would be smaller than 10 by 30 because my denominator is more. Hence, this value is smaller than that one. Okay, so if I ask you in which year the percentage change is minimum, my answer is said to be that one, that is 25% in year 2002. Okay, so just go for approximation if there is a need to check. Here it's a clear cut question. I have to find the percentage, I have to find the simple growth rate. 40% is maximum in 2001. Right? Second point here is note in 2 years. Now it is given, suppose if I ask you what is the simple growth rate from year 99 to 2003. Question is, what is the simple growth rate in production from 99 to 2003? Now in 99, 2 lakh, 2003, 6 lakh. Right? You have to find the simple growth rate. Change is 4 lakh by 2 lakh into 100. So you can say your answer is said to be 200%. That becomes your answer. Okay? If we ask you what is the simple growth rate, here I can say that is said to be 200%. Right? So here I hope you clear the concept. Simple growth and simple growth rate. The second point, the third point is average growth rate or average annual growth rate. Now, what do you mean by this? Suppose if I say, what is the average annual growth rate? Annual growth rate. When rate is given, then you have to find the percentage. If only growth is given, then there is no need to find out the percentage, right? What is the average annual growth rate from 1999 to 2003? That's the information, right? Now one step, first step that you have to take, total is 200%, you have taken, okay? Now, you have to find the average annual. It means you have to divide by time periods. Time period means how many years are there. From 1999 to 2003, how many years have been passed? 1999 to 2001, 2000 to 2001, 1, 2, 3 and 4. I have to divide by 4, my answer is said to be 50%. Here we don't need to divide by 5. Sometimes we commit a mistake. Generally we divide it by 5. That makes my question wrong. A very important point here to understand. In any question, if you have to find out average annual growth rate, in that case, total percentage have to be divided by time periods. Right? Here question is simple growth rate have to be divided by time periods. Simple growth rate have to be divided by time periods. From there we are able to get our answer. My time periods are 4 years, 1999 to 2000, 1, 2, 3 and 4 divided by 4. So I can say my answer is said to be 50%. I hope the idea is clear. Right? So just to have that thing in your mind, whenever you have to find average annual growth rate, you have to divide by time periods. Okay? Now, let us have the fourth point here, compounded annual growth rate. When I talk about the compounded annual growth rate, suppose here he asks from you, what is the CAGR, compounded annual growth rate, from 99 to 2003, that you have to find out, okay? Now, in finding compounded annual growth rate, apply the basic concept of compound interest. Apply the formula for amount in compound interest, you know that principal is 2 lakh. Rate of interest you have to find out 1 plus R by 100. Power is time period. From here we are finding 99 to 2003. Power is 4. And this is equal to 6 lakh. You have to write it equal to 6 lakh. And you have to solve it and find the approximate value of R. Now what I can say, that will be divided. It would be 1 plus R by 100. Raised to power 4 is equal to 3. Now I know here power is 4. So I have to make under root twice. If I take first under root, you will get 1.732. If we take one more under root, then go for approximate values, right? How? If I take one more under root of this, so I can say that would be quite close to. Just take any option. You know that 1.3 is 1.69, 1.4 is 1.96. Here my answer is somewhere quite close to 1.32 or 1.33, right? Okay. In that case, either my interest rate would be 32% or 33%. Generally, in these type of questions, option are not very close. Some gap have been there in the options. So there you can approximately answer it. Either it is 1.32% or 1.33. From there, if I put it equal to 1 plus R by 100, so I can say R is either equal to 32 or 33%. I am able to get my answer, right? So in case of compounded annual growth rate, we have to apply the formula for the concept of compound interest, that you know that principal into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to power T. Accordingly, you can answer it. The next point that we discuss here is the relation between the term percentage and percentage points. It's a very important point here because in DI generally we use it. We use two terms. First one is percentage, right? Second one is percentage point, percent point. That is percent points, right? With an example, I just want to state you what is given to us. In 1999, salary of a person was 20,000. In 2000, it was 2200. In 2001, it was 2500. It was 25,000. And in 2002, it was 30,000. That is provided to us. Okay. Now, if I ask you the question that from 2001 to 2002, what is the percentage change? What is the percentage change? So I can simply find out. 5000 by 25000 into 100, my percentage increase is 20%. That is said to be 20%, right? Now the question is, in 2003, the salary of A was increased by 5% more then increased in 2002, right? We have to find what is the salary of A in 2003, right? What the question is, in 2003, salary of A was increased by 5% more as compared to 2002 in 2003, right? Now, it is given that 5% more, that means from 2002, what is the percentage change? It was 20%. Now in 2003, it was 5% more than that. First of all, I will find 5% of it. That is 1%. 500, that is equal to 1. It means I can say in 2003, salary totally increased by 21%. Salary totally increased by 21%. What I can say, as per to this question, in 2003, salary of the person was 36,300. Because in 2002 it was 30,000 and it was increased by 5% more. Here it is given 5% more. That is percentage change, right? And if I change my question, it is given that it was increased by 5% point more. 5% point more, right? Now my answer will be changed. Why? Because 5% point, it simply means here it is 20%, because now I have to change it by 5% point more. It means now change should be 25%. Now change should be 25%. That means 30,000 I have to make increase of 25%. That is 7,500. So I can say now in 2003, salary of the person is equal to 37,500. That becomes my answer as per to this particular question. I hope the idea is clear. With that example, you can easily understand that what is the basic difference between the term percentage and percent point, right? Percentage is a relative change. In 20%, if I have to make a change of 5%, it means I have to first find 5% of 20%, that is 1, and 20 plus 1, my answer is said to be 21%, okay? Now, in the second case, I have to find percent point, right? Percent point is an absolute quantity, right? If I have to make 5% increase in 5% increase in 20%, it means I can say that I have to be changed by 25%, right? After this, the next point that we have to understand is the association of value and volume. We have to understand these two terms, value and volume. वैल्यू एंड वॉल्यूम, राइट? सपोज ए कंपनीज टेबल इज गिवन फॉर ए कंपनी, बी कंपनी एंड सी कंपनी. सपोज वी हैव अ थ्री टाइप ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स अवेलेबल एंड द सेल्स इज गिवन एट द एंड ऑफ द ईयर इन द टर्म्स ऑफ वैल्यू एंड वॉल्यूम, राइट? इट इज गिवन दैट सेल्स ऑफ ए वाज 1 मिलियन, वैल्यू वाइज 1 मिलियन रुपीज, सेल्स इन रुपीज, राइट? वी कैन से सेल्स ऑफ ए वाज गिवन एज 1 मिलियन एंड वैल्यू वाइज इट इज 2500 एंड द वॉल्यूम वाइज दैट इज क्वांटिटी इट इज 2500. सेल्स ऑफ बी वाज इक्वल टू 1 करोड़ एंड हियर इट इज 4000. सेल्स ऑफ सी वाज 1 बिलियन एंड हियर इट इज 20,000, राइट? नाउ इफ आई आस्क यू आउट ऑफ एबीसी वोज प्रोडक्ट एवरेज प्राइस इज मैक्सिमम. क्वेश्चन इज आउट ऑफ एबीसी वोज प्रोडक्ट एवरेज प्राइस इज मैक्सिमम. नाउ हियर पॉइंट टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट दिस इज वैल्यू वाइज. वैल्यू मीन्स टोटल रेवेन्यू, इट मीन्स टोटल वैल्यू इन द टर्म्स ऑफ रूपीज. वॉल्यूम मीन्स क्वांटिटी, मीन्स माई टोटल क्वांटिटी सोल्ड इज 2500 एंड द मनी दैट आई रिसीव दैट इज 1 मिलियन, राइट? हियर ऑल्सो देयर इज अ नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट दिस मिलियन. इन द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ दिस लेक्चर आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट. 1 मिलियन वी नो दैट दैट इज इक्वल टू 10 लाख, दैट इज इक्वल टू 10 लाख, राइट? एंड माई क्वांटिटी इज 2500, आई कैन फाइंड द एवरेज प्राइस. That is 4, so I can say average price is rupees 400. Okay? In the second case, 1 crore 4000. Now I can say 1 crore, number of zeros are 7. In 1 crore, total zeros are 7 divided by 4000. Okay? So that would be cancelled out. 4 will go on 25, so I can say my average price was 2500. Right? Third case, 1 billion. 1 billion is 9 zeros are there. Right, 1, 3, 3, 6 and 3, 9. Divide by 20,000. I have to find the price. 4, 0 would be cancelled out. 2 will go on 5. Right, here I can say this is 50,000. Right, if my question is in which year the price was the minimum, I can say that is in A. Here price was 400. If I say price is maximum, I can say 50,000. So in the question you have to pay attention to volume and volume. Value and volume, we know we can say that volume, that is quantity basically, into price is always equal to value. I hope the idea is clear, right? Similarly, suppose if I say only three companies are there, only the three companies are there in the market, those if I ask you about what is the market share of A volume wise, question is what is the market share of A volume wise? So here you have to pay attention in the question that whether he is concerned with value wise or volume wise. He is asking that market share of A volume wise, it means I can say total volume sold, that is 20,000 plus 4,000, that is 24,226. So I can say 26,500. And share of A was 2500 into 100. Just you have to solve, that is your approximate. We can say that is the percentage market share volume wise, right? And if we ask you value wise, in that case, add all the three, divide by that. In numerator, it should be 1 million into 100. So that we can say that is the percentage share of A in terms of value wise, right? So here it is very important for you to understand in the question that what is the basic difference between the term value wise and volume wise, right? The next point here is to understand about different units that we use generally, because sometimes we have to change it and here that creates a problem. We are just going to concern with number of zeros. In 10,000, we can say number of zeros are 4, right? 1 lakh, number of zeros are 5. 1 million, 1 million is always equal to 10 lakhs, right? 1 million is 10 lakhs, or we can say that is 10 raised to power 6. 1 million is always equal to 10 raised to power 6, 1 crore. 1 crore is equal to 100 lakhs, or we can say that is 10 raised to power 7, right? After that we have 1 billion. 1 billion is 10 raised to power 9. Million, 10 raised to power 6. Billion, 10 raised to power 9. 1 trillion. 10 raised to power 12. If you have to take 1, a trillion, that is said to be 10 raised to power 12. 1 quadrillion. Quadrillion. That is said to be 10 raised to power 15. It depends on the question what is specified there. So these things must be have in your mind. Whenever we talk about 1 billion, that is 10 raised to power 6. Okay, 1 billion, that is said to be 10 raised to power 9. 1 a trillion, that is said to be 10 raised to power 12. Right? So as per to the question, you can convert the values and solve it. In last, because that is the introduction to the basic things that all these are required for solving the question of the DI. So in last, 4 principles you have to always take care in your mind, or we can say 4 things must always be in your mind. First one is read question carefully. Read directions of the questions carefully. Directions carefully. Because from the direction you can only understand what is provided in the graph. Either in a table or bar. If you directly look at the graph, you cannot observe what exactly is provided. Sometime in hurry, we directly look at the graph and start to solve our calculations. That is not expected from you. You have to read the directions carefully, because only directions can help you to understand what exactly is given in the graph. Second point, read question carefully and do only that calculations that is required for a particular questions. Do that calculation that is required for a question. Don't solve the whole question. Sometime, suppose if I say 5 schools are there, A, B, C, D, E, total strength is given and percentage of boys are given. Right? So you are only, suppose if I say I am going to find out the number of boys in B school. So there is no need to find all values, just only find for B. Sometimes we commit a mistake, we just go for calculating all the values, that is going to create a problem. Third thing, units have to be taken care of. Units mentioned in the question have to be taken care of. Sometime he may specify in percentage, but he don't specify percentage symbol there. Right? So there we commit a mistake, because for understanding that, there is a need to read the direction carefully. If you don't understand it, then it's going to create a problem. Units have to be taken care of. Sometime in the question it is given in kilogram, in the answer it is given in milligram, right? So that means you must aware about it. Sometime in question he is talking in the terms of the million, and in the answer he is that have been given in billion. So there is need to convert. If you don't convert, it is going to create a fuss. It's going to make the question to be wrong, right? Next important point is, don't find exact answers. Don't find exact answers. Go for approximations. Go for approximations. Now, approximation is something, it's not a technique, or I can say it's not a thing. It's not a formula that I can teach here on the board. It is a skill set. When we solve different varieties of problem, a number of problems, by looking at the options, somewhere we are going to find a value. There is no need to calculate, but we are answer it. So approximation is sort of a skill, and that I may help you to understand while explaining you the different questions on the board in the practice sessions. Because earlier I told you, in these sessions of the DI, I am going to provide around 50 to 70 practice sessions in which you will be comfortable with the things. It takes some time, but sooner you will find all the practice sessions on my channel. Right? Now, that's a basic introduction to the DI. In the second session, we try to understand the different type of graphs, table, pie chart, line graph. What are basic requirements for that? Because in table, I don't think so there is a need to understand anything. But in pie chart, something are required to you. In line graph, in order to find the percentage change, something may be taught to you. So in the next session, we'll try to understand the different type of graphs. And after that, you will find two or three sessions. First, you have the basic level sessions on each type of graph. And then we start with the jumbled sessions on different graphs. Thank you very much.